Hi, my name is Tiffany and I'm a GMAT instructor with Manhattan Prep. Today I will be guiding you through an expert level quant problem. Take 2 minutes first and attempt this on your own before we dive in together. When I see a word problem like this, I really love to jump to the question at the end before I read all of the information because it really grounds me in what I'm looking for. So here our question starts with, how much money will Mitchell be paid in total during the summer if he works for the entire duration of an 8-week long camp? This already grounds me in some of the context that we're looking at. He's working for a camp. We want to know how much he's being paid in total. I'm guessing he's being paid on some other basis that we'll need to know. Okay, he plans to work at a day camp. Yeah, check, we know that. Each week he'll be paid according to the following schedule. Okay, this is where it's getting good. At the end of the first week, he'll receive $1. I'm not sure why Mitchell agreed to work for this camp because he is definitely being underpaid. At the end of each subsequent week, he'll receive $1 plus an additional amount equal to the sum of all payments he's received in previous weeks. So this is, I'm gonna think of as like the total up to that point. Total to that point. All right, so each week he gets $1 and then plus the total of whatever he's received so far. When I see a problem like this, especially one that there's this tricky, weird sort of pattern that we're following along to add numbers together, I'm thinking, I have got to get organized. A lot of my students will come to me and say, I don't have time to get organized. I just have to jump in. You don't have time to not get organized. All right, so here is how I would organize this. I already know that we're working with weeks and that these are very important, right? This is our structure. The next thing I understand is that while I want to know the total pay, we're going to need to calculate weekly pay along the way. Finally, I definitely want to be tracking total pay because this is really the question that I want to be answering. That was quick. So once you actually understand the problem and you take a second to think about the information that you're giving, the organizational structure is going to follow. All right, so we've got weeks 1, 2, 3, 4. At this point, I'm also thinking, wow, I really might have to calculate all the way to week 8, but I would really prefer if I didn't have to. So there might be some kind of a pattern along the way based on the way that this payment structure is working out that allows me to jump to the end. I'm anticipating that that's going to happen, and I'm trying to keep an eye out for it. All right, at the end of the first week, then Mitchell received his $1. Not a great paycheck. In week 2, then he receives $1 plus the sum total of all else he's been paid, which still is just $1 to this point, right? So end of week 2, he gets $2. His total pay so far is $2 plus the previous one, so we're at 3. In week 3, he gets his $1 again plus the total previous, which is 3. So here he gets 4. I'm seeing kind of a pattern emerging here. And then his total pay is 7. Week 4, I'm gonna do it one more time just to make sure I understand the pattern fully. I see 1 plus the previous 7. So he gets paid $8 in week 4. It's starting to look a little bit better for him, but still not great. And then his total is 15. So I'm definitely seeing the pattern now here. All right, this is 2 to the 1. 2 to the 2, 2 to the 3. I'm also seeing that these numbers follow a similar pattern, and this is ultimately the column that we care about, right? So 2 to the 2 is 4, for example. This previous week is 2 to the 2 minus 1. Same deal here, 7 is 1 less than 8. So this is 2 to the 3 minus 1. So this total pay, the exponent on your 2 here tracks along with the weekly number, which means we can just jump right down to week 8 at this point, trusting the pattern that we see emerging, and say that this is going to be 2 to the 8 minus 1. We have just skipped so much work. By noticing this pattern, by getting organized, we have skipped so much calculation that you now don't have to do. Give yourself a pat on the back for that. All right, so 2 to the 8 minus 1. In general, it's worth knowing the powers of 2 up to 2 to the 8. So if you don't know what that is off the top of your head, it's worth memorizing those. However, I have another useful trick for you called benchmarking. So 2 to the 8, we can divide up into 2 to the 4 times 2 to the 4. Now, 2 to the 4 minus 1 is going to be our 15 right here. So we know 2 to the 4 is going to be 16. So this is really just 16 times 16. If we're going to do some benchmarking with that because you don't know 2 to the 8, for example, then what you can do really easily is think about numbers that are around that zone. So we'll do 10 times 10, which is a really easy number to calculate, and 20 times 20, which is another pretty easy number to calculate. So that's going to be 400. Now we have 300 points between these two. So the mid mark, which is around 16 times 16, right? It's just a little bit on the higher side of the midpoint. The mid mark is going to be between these two. So 300 divided by 2 is 150, which means this mid mark is going to be right around 250. Let's take a look at our answer choices. Clearly A and B are out. E is definitely out. C and D are closer, but we already see 250 right here as our benchmark. So D is clearly going to be the correct option in this case. We don't have to do any more math at this point. All right, so a couple of key points from this problem. Number one, you do not have time to be disorganized. If you start to write this problem out and just track, okay, here's week one, week two, wait, what was that one? Wait, why did I write this number? You will run out of time. Make sure that you get yourself organized. Make sure that you're on the lookout for specific patterns. Those patterns will save you some additional time that you can devote to other problems. And then key lesson number 3, benchmark when you're able. If you don't know what a specific number is, 2 to the 8th, for example, you just still don't have to do all of the math. You can think about it logically. All right, thanks for tuning in and happy studying. Subscribe for more GMAT Math Spotlight videos from Manhattan Prep and leave us a comment telling us how you solved this problem. Happy studying.